Doesn't this take you back, Kavan?
Oh, yes, oui. Oh, yes,
very, oui. I feel like I am in a French bistro. But actually, we are in our kitchen here at Home and Family.
Really?
And Kavan Smith and Pascal Hutton have stuck around. They are here in honor of June wedding.
Yes.
We are so excited.
They stuck around, didn't they?
They stuck around because Pascal, well, wants to see Kavan make his famous crepes.
Yeah, the pressure's on.
And we want to find out how you make these famous crepes. You have a very secret way to make them perfect, correct?
Wow, so secret, I'm not gonna share it.
No, thank you for joining us, everyone.
Yeah, I've been doing these for a long time. Started when I was 5, and I'm 20 now, so I've been making them 15 years. I've been doing these for a long time.
We're gonna dig in.
Since you were 5,
dig in, please.
How does one begin to even learn to make a crepe at 5 years old?
My nanny showed me how to do these.
Your nanny showed you how to make
Because I'm addicted to crepes. Most people usually are, and I fell in love with them, so I just, she started showing me at a young age. Should I show you how to do this?
You should show us.
Okay.
We should add that your nanny actually had gone to Cordon Bleu.
She did. My nanny taught at Cordon Bleu school. So these are I've modified the recipe over the years, and you can do a lot of different things with crepes. So basically, it's flour, equal parts flour and milk.
Okay. Isn't it just a skinny pancake?
Mm-hmm. It's a skinny pancake.
Isn't that what it is?
Kind of.
With some love.
Yeah.
So you just kind of keep it moving around, and then we'll throw in the eggs. So it's usually about 2 cups of flour, 2 cups of milk, 3 eggs. I like mine a little eggier, a little more custardy.
Right. Mm.
So you turn that in. We get a little bit of the oats.
Oh, that's okay.
Don't spill the butter.
Butter, we need more
butter. Well, you're making a healthier version.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Let's go with that.
Less butter.
So it's about 2 to 3 tablespoons of butter, a little shot, about maybe a half teaspoon or so of vanilla,
right,
and then a pinch of salt, and
sugar.
About 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now, that was so nice.
There you go.
That for
you were well
So we didn't have to look at it.
No worries. So we don't want our bistro to be a mess.
Yeah, exactly.
Customers will never come back.
No, they won't.
Okay.
Very demanding customers. So you give it a good stir like this, and you want it to get nice and smooth, get all those lumps out.
So what's the key to the perfect batter, though?
The key to the batter really is to let it rest. Now that it's done, you want it about the consistency of whipping cream. So I'd normally put it just maybe a little looser than this.
Right.
But you got to let it sit for 15 minutes to half an hour at least. You want the gluten to relax after stirring.
Right.
And then you want all the flour molecules to hydrate.
Oh.
And it'll just make a much better batter.
That's also the key to parenting.
It really is. It really is.
Let it rest, people.
But maybe more than half an hour.
Right.
As long as you can get.
Could you put this in the refrigerator, make it the day before, and then?
Absolutely.
Or is it too long?
No, actually, it's even better. So if you make this overnight, you can add beer, you can add rum. It really brings all sorts of different flavors.
Won't the beer fluff it up?
No, it doesn't. Overnight, it just leaves a little effervescent thing to it, get a little bit of zip on it. You can play with crepes. You can do almost anything with them.
Okay, so now we have our perfect batter. But I also know that the French are very particular about their crepe pans.
Yes.
So do we need a special pan?
Absolutely. I highly recommend. You can get these crepe pans almost anywhere. The big box stores have them. But sometimes they have that coating on it that I'm not so sure about. So I think you should invest in a decent crepe pan. It's not that bad. It's about $50.
Okay.
I use it at least once a week. You get your money's worth.
So this is your special pan.
This is mine. I brought it from home. I told Pascal that. She laughed at me and made fun of me.
Of course you brought your own pan. Yeah.
Which you actually purchased in Paris when he was, did you say, when you were courting your wife?
Aww.
Nobody says courting anymore, apparently. I'm aging myself. Terribly.
So do we have to get that pan piping hot?
You want it warm and hot. This is an induction stove, so I don't know what's going to happen right
now.
This is just like Wild West stuff. So you take a little bit of oil on a paper towel, get it going like that.
There we go.
A little smoke is okay. Too much,
bad thing.
And then we get our measuring spoon, and we're going to go up like this.
So if I make these, and I do like with my pancakes, I throw the first one out. Is that acceptable in crepe making?
Usually the first one does get wasted, but in our house, we actually have a bit of a thing that we do. My dog gets the first one.
Nice.
So she comes and sits by the stove, and she puts her face up like that, and she just waits patiently. Doesn't say anything or bark anything. We have strict rules in my house. And then she sits there and she waits, and then I lay the crepe over her face. And she doesn't do anything. She has
really?
To sit. Yeah, if she starts to move, I take it back. I'm like, no. So I put it on her face, and then as soon as I snap my fingers, she pops it up and eats the crepe.
Oh.
Isn't that fantastic?
Do you do the same thing with your kids?
No, I know. So normally I would do the whole thing, but on TV the pressure's on. So, so we
you
just
didn't
you start
do the whole thing where you like smooth it out. You didn't do
that's
that.
That's on a different machine. That's like a crepe stone where you use a trowel. Yeah. This is in a pan itself.
So you just
do around. Okay. The like I said, the batter is just a little bit.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
So you just roll it over.
So what you have to do though, is you have to go like this when you make them.
Yeah, you swirl it around. Okay. It'll be a little looser than this, maybe the batter, and you get a nice swirl. Use one of these beautiful little things, and you can fill in all the bubbles and stuff.
Did you bring that as well?
This is not mine. She made fun of me because I brought my own crepe pan. I know.
Do kids love to make these or just love to eat them?
They do. They both kids. I have a 7 and a 10-year-old, and both of them can do this.
Oh, really?
Probably better than me.
Wow.
They should be on the show.
You taught them early?
Yeah, I guess it would have been around 5, too. Yeah.
So this is a family tradition.
Oh, yeah. Every weekend. Every Saturday. This is... Okay.
It's ready?
Should we go for it?
Let's go.
No.
Oh, we're going to flip it.
Flip it?
Now, I'm risking this because if it drops...
Am I supposed to catch it or what?
No, it's not that. I hear all the producers freaking out. Oh, God, don't do that! No. I'm not going to do it. So all you do is just slide that baby right there. Turned out okay.
How do you prefer your crepes?
Now, normally,
it could be controversial.
It can. You can do anything with a crepe, but I'm going to do what my kids like best. Okay. So you take the golden side, you want that down, and you're going to take this side. All I do is I put, normally we'd let this cool a little bit because this is going to go through my whipped cream quite quickly. You just fold it in half.
Oh my
and God. I usually add a little lemon zest to my whipped cream too. And then I fold it into quarters like this. And then you slide it in the middle of the plate, little bit of maple syrup on top.
You could make these savory, couldn't you?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, that's usually what I do. The recipe that I gave you is usually enough on a pan about this size, it'll make about 15 crepes. And we go, there's only 4 of us in our family. I'll do one, my wife does one, my little guy does one, and my big guy does 2. So that leaves us a bunch left over, and we never waste anything. So you just get one of these, just like this, you put the crepe back on, you can put them in the fridge for a few hours, and then when lunchtime comes around, you throw one down here, you add a little bit of shredded cheese, some leftover chicken, maybe some scallions or something.
Gosh.
Some spinach, put it on top, put the lid on top, it'll just melt and do its thing. When it's ready.
It's a gourmet quesadilla.
It's really good. It's basically what it is. And then you take a squirt of mayonnaise, a squirt of sriracha, fold it up, slide it onto a plate.
I'm feeling a little shortchanged here.
Sorry.
We just got a little whipped cream in the middle, right?
Okay, you're gonna taste this.
Did it turn out
amazing? Wow.
Okay. So good. By the way, the full recipe is available by dropping by our website, and be sure to catch Kavan and Pascal in The Perfect Bride, Wedding Bells, a part of June Weddings, right here on Hallmark Channel.